Capital, Part 1 of 3. By Karl Marx. Audiobook 12x55. Therefore the labor time requisite for the production of labor power reduces itself to that necessary for the production of those means of subsistence. In other words, the value of labor power is the value of the means of subsistence necessary for the maintenance of the laborer. Labor power, however, becomes a reality only by its exercise. It sets itself in action only by working. But thereby a definite quantity of human muscle, nerve, brain, etc., is wasted, and these require to be restored. This increased expenditure demands a larger income. If the owner of labor power works today, tomorrow he must again be able to repeat the same process in the same conditions as regards health and strength. His means of subsistence must therefore be sufficient to maintain him in his normal state as a laboring individual. His natural wants, such as food, clothing, fuel, and housing, vary according to the climatic and other physical conditions of his country. On the other hand, the number and extent of his so-called necessary wants, as also the modes of satisfying them, are themselves the product of historical development, and depend therefore to a great extent on the degree of civilization of a country, more particularly on the conditions under which, and consequently on the habits and degree of comfort in which, the class of free laborers has been formed. In contradistinction therefore to the case of other commodities, there enters into the determination of the value of labor power a historical and moral element. Nevertheless, in a given country, at a given period, the average quantity of the means of subsistence necessary for the laborer is practically known. The owner of labor power is mortal. If then his appearance in the market is to be continuous, and the continuous conversion of money into capital assumes this, the seller of labor power must perpetuate himself, in the way that every living individual perpetuates himself, by procreation. The labor power withdrawn from the market by wear and tear and death, must be continually replaced by, at the very least, an equal amount of fresh labor power. Hence the sum of the means of subsistence necessary for the production of labor power must include the means necessary for the laborer's substitutes, i.e., his children, in order that this race of peculiar commodity owners may perpetuate its appearance in the market. In order to modify the human organism, so that it may acquire skill and handiness in a given branch of industry, and become labor power of a special kind, a special education or training.